Here at Tormach, we want to help you make things. So here's how to install your automatic collet closer on the 15L SLAM Pro lathe. Please read the technical documentation that came with your product for all warnings, cautions, and potentially small changes in future releases.
When you receive your collet closer, compare the contents to the item list in the included technical document. If any of these items are missing, contact Tormach customer service at support@tormach.com. Before you begin the installation of the automatic collet closer, you will need to install PathPilot 2.0 or later onto your controller. If you have not done so, order the upgrade, part number 38249, from Tormach's website. Since this comes on a USB stick, allow several days for its arrival. The technical document also includes a list of tools necessary for the collet closer installation. Make sure you have these on hand. It is recommended to use a filter regulator lubricator. If you plan to do so, then it should be ordered to arrive with the collet closer. Assembling the pneumatic cylinder. The draw tube has four holes on one end, which are used to secure the draw tube to the pneumatic cylinder. Insert the other end of the draw tube into the outward facing end of the pneumatic cylinder until it is flush. Align the four draw tube holes with the set screws and tighten with a 3/16 hex wrench. Take the two NPT reducers and use thread seal tape to wrap each end. Thread the NPT reducers onto the pneumatic cylinder and tighten with the 9/16 wrench. Thread the elbow fittings onto the NPT reducers and tighten with an 11/16 wrench. Set this aside for now. Removing the belt guard cover. The SLAM Pro will need to be powered off. Push in the emergency stop button. On PathPilot, click Exit. Turn the main disconnect to off. On the left side of the machine, disconnect the power connector from the rotary encoder. With a Phillips screwdriver, remove the three screws from the encoder cover and set these aside. Then remove the four screws from the spindle bore cover. These can be discarded. Use a Phillips screwdriver to remove the five screws that secure the belt guard cover to the enclosure and the stand. Set aside the belt guard cover and its screws. Installing the anti-rotation bracket. Slide two rubber bumpers onto the anti-rotation bracket. With the belt guard cover removed, temporarily secure the anti-rotation bracket to the two left screw holes using the M5 button head cap screws. Make sure that the screws are centered within the slots on the anti-rotation bracket. Use a marker to mark the hole locations on the belt guard cover on the center of each open slot. Remove the button head cap screws and set the anti-rotation bracket aside. Pre-drill holes in the center of the two marked locations on the belt cover. Then use a 7/32 drill bit to finish drilling the holes. Remove any burrs from the holes. Secure the anti-rotation bracket onto the belt guard cover with the four M5 button head cap screws and four M5 nuts. Installing the adapter spacer. Use a machinist stone to lightly stone the face of the spindle pulley. Make sure to remove all the burrs, which could cause runout. Then soak a rag in alcohol and use it to wipe off the residue. Align the spindle pulley with the four holes on the adapter spacer. Use a 10mm hex wrench and four M6 hex head flange bolts to attach the adapter spacer to the spindle pulley. To prevent the spacer from spinning, either pinch the belts with one hand or hold onto a chuck that has been inserted into the spindle. Reinstalling the belt guard cover. Slide the belt guard cover back into place and re-secure it with the five screws set aside earlier. Use a Phillips screwdriver to attach the encoder cover. Resecure the power connector to the rotary encoder. Installing the pneumatic cylinder assembly. Slide the pneumatic assembly into the spindle while making sure its fittings slide into the anti-rotation bracket. Make sure the thumb screw is aligned with the flat on the adapter spacer. Use four M6 hex head screws to finger tighten the pneumatic cylinder assembly to the adapter spacer. Make sure the screws are snug but not tightened completely. Loosen the thumb screw on the pneumatic cylinder assembly. Loosening the thumb screw allows the draw tube to rotate separately from the spindle. Make sure the 5C insert is installed in the spindle. Install a collet into the 5C insert. You must rotate the collet until its groove aligns in the 5C insert. Insert a piece of stock into the collet. Hold the collet with one hand and then use the other hand to turn the draw tube handle. Continue to thread the collet into the draw tube until it's completely threaded. Tighten the thumb screw on the pneumatic cylinder assembly. Turn the draw tube handle counterclockwise until the thumb screw clicks into one of the four slots in the draw tube. Making air connections. You must make sure that the air to the solenoid is dry, filtered, and regulated. If it is not, we recommend you use a filter regulator lubricator. If you are not using an FRL, then go to the technical document for the instructions in the Making Air Connections section. Use two M4 button head cap screws to attach the solenoid to the back of the anti-rotation bracket. Follow the instructions included with the FRL to attach the NPT reducers. The push-to-connect fitting attaches to the input side of the FRL, and the elbow attaches to the output side. Then attach the FRL to the front of the bracket with the M5 button head cap screws. Plug the solenoid's power cord into the closer outlet on the back of the Slant Pro lathe. Four air tubes are provided with the kit. One long, two medium, and the fourth is short. The first medium air tube is connected to port A on the solenoid, and the other end to the cylinder elbow closest to the Slant Pro lathe. The second medium air tube connects to port B on the solenoid, and the other end to the second elbow on the cylinder. Then take the short air tube and connect one end into the FRL output port, and the other end to port P. Use thread seal tape to wrap the threads of the quick connect fitting. Install that fitting into the elbow with the 9/16 and 11/16 wrenches. Connect the long air tube to the elbow and the other end to the input port on the FRL. The quick connect can then be connected to the air compressor, aligning the automatic collet closer kit with the 15L Slant Pro spindle. Put the base of a magnetic dial indicator on the top of the belt guard cover. Make sure that the dial indicator contacts the aluminum of the pneumatic cylinder furthest away from the belt guard cover. Rotate the spindle clockwise until the needle reaches the highest point on the dial indicator. Use a pair of dead blow hammers to gently tap the mounting flange. Rotate the spindle again until the needle reaches the highest point. Repeat the tap on the flange. If you see no effect on the dial indicator after striking the flange, then loosen the screws slightly. Continue these steps until the measured runout is less than 2/1000ths of an inch on the dial indicator. Tighten the four M6 hex screws with a 10mm hex wrench. Power on the machine and the PathPilot controller by turning on the main disconnect switch to the on position. On the operator box, twist out the emergency stop button and press the start button. Operating the automatic collet closer. G-codes can be used to automatically operate the collet closer. An M10 command opens the collet closer. An M11 command closes the collet closer. To manually operate the collet closer, click collet clamped on the PathPilot interface to toggle the green light on. The collet closer will now be in closed position. Changing the collet, from the PathPilot interface, click collet clamped to toggle the button light off. The collet is now in the open position. Loosen the thumb screw on the pneumatic cylinder assembly. Make sure the 5C insert is installed in the spindle. Install a collet into the 5C insert. You must rotate the collet until its groove aligns in the 5C insert. Hold the collet with one hand and then, from the pneumatic cylinder, use the other hand to turn the draw tube handle. Continue to thread the collet onto the draw tube until it is completely threaded. Tighten the thumb screw on the pneumatic cylinder assembly. Turn the draw tube handle counterclockwise until the thumb screw clicks into one of the four slots on the draw tube. Switching between ID and OD clamping. Open the setting tab and select ID or OD. The holding force can be adjusted by either increasing or decreasing the pressure on the pressure regulator. We recommend you begin with 40 PSI and then gradually increase the pressure until the part is sufficiently held. This concludes the installation of the automatic collet closer kit for the 15L Slant Pro lathe. If you have other issues with your installation, please contact technical support at support@tormach.com.
Thanks for watching. Check out all of our latest videos here. And for more metalworking tips, tricks, and stories, subscribe to our YouTube channel.